I noticed there's something on my table, Cheryl. Could you tell me what this is?
What does
it
look like?
It looks like feathers to me.
Why would there be feathers on the table?
I don't know. Why would there be feathers on the table?
Maybe if there was a chicken, maybe, in here?
A chicken?
Yeah, I think there's something with Peter and a chicken. Maybe.
I don't know.
You want to turn the dog around? You think that would be a good idea to see?
Yeah, let's see what's on the other side.
I absolutely love the chicken and Peter Griffin fight scenes. Always, they're always very entertaining. So I wanted to most definitely portray that. So I've got all my favorite characters on there.
Has once again saved Bowser and his evil clippers. No shave down for this doggy. Now on to the next villain.
This lucky ladybug has landed here to stay, to make my garden pretty and keep the weeds away.
Oh, come on, everybody. Oh, ladybugs. Next, we have Cheryl Grain with Impress Monsters Under the Bed, huh?
Yes, monsters under the bed, in the bedroom, anywhere they could be.
And are you afraid of the dark?
No, it's actually my grandkids are afraid to go in their bedroom. They're afraid of monsters. And the only monster that's ever in there would be Empress.
I think he's more scared than the monsters are. We have Kevin Nippenberg. See, I did practice at some of them. And he has Donnie, and you have Road for a Cure. Roar for a Cure.
Right. Yeah. It came from the song I really fell in love with, the Katy Perry song, Roar, and they could play it if they want while I'm talking. That way we can. But why I did it was my aunt passed away due to cancer, and I wanted to bring awareness to cancer. And my wife had a scare of cancer about 2 years ago. So it kind of, the song took good meaning to me, and that's why I wanted to kind of bring it to life. I also had Amber Powell Brooks do a drawing for me of it, and that made me want to do it even more.
Well, that's very inspirational. Can we turn around so we can see the other side?
The line's supposed to be over here on the other side with the...
And I've heard that you're pretty new to the scene. You've only been in the creator for a couple of years, but you've come a long way, huh?
Such wonderful things around you. What more are you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we've been putting full time to floating under the sea. Doggy or the fish is happy.
Well, why don't we turn around and see the other side, and Skip can play the music.
The only way to get what you want is to become a human yourself.
Can you do that?
My dear, sweet child, that's what I do. It's what I live for, to help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls with no one else to turn to. I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me well.
All right, let's hear it for Gus and the Little Fermaid. And the People's Choice, $250. And this amazing trophy is going to go to... Super Nintendo Dog!
Thank you.
So third place in creative, sponsored by Groomer to Groomer, is going to receive a check for $500, and that is going to go to Bryn Hines, Super Nintendo Dog. Come on, people, let's hear it! Our creative second place is going to go to Kat Opson with Groom Under the Sea. The 2014 PetQuest Creative Styling Champion is going to receive this lovely trophy. A check for $1,500 from Groomer to Groomer. And that's going to go to Popeye, Angela Compey.